My name's Kevin Jarbo, and I am a third-year graduate student here in CMU's psychology department, and I'm interested in looking at how we integrate perceptual information and reward information to update our decisions that we make. In my current project, I'm doing this study. The experiment's called Danger Zone, and we have people presented with a group of white dots, which is a target, and a group of red dots, which is the danger zone. So the goal for this particular experiment is to have the participants use a mouse to select the center of the white group of dots, which is the target. And so they score higher by picking closer to the target zone. In this particular task, it's looking at how we change the variance, which is basically how far apart the dots are in the target zone, which makes a harder perceptual decision for people to make, and whether or not we have penalty on any given trial. There's this sort of competition or this balance between our perception and the reinforcement signals that we're getting. When I was in high school, I had no idea that I would even pursue graduate school, honestly. I like biology more than any of the other sciences, and I actually majored in biology as an undergrad, but I really had this passion for kind of understanding people and how people's brains worked. I just wanted to figure out ways to get at the heart of what is it about us that's the same but makes us act different. And so I started working in a cognitive neuroscience / psychology lab, which was cool because I got to try to understand behavior, but then get to do cool stuff like use functional magnetic resonance imaging, fMRI, to see how people's brains were active during different types of behaviors. And so that sort of thing was like amazing to me. And that's where I really got my start and my love for what I'm doing now, and getting this extra guidance from Tim to push me to answer these questions using different sorts of modalities and tools is more than I could ask for. I'm very interested in how people learn, how we use different sorts of information to learn to choose the correct behaviors in a given scenario. Sometimes when we're faced with a really difficult decision, we don't always make the best choice. You don't want to go to a job interview wearing a tank top and flip-flops, something like that. Based off the information we have, informs you about how you should dress. Maybe you might see reward as being like how comfortable you are in a given outfit doing a given activity. I get the greatest sense of satisfaction by getting to solve problems every single day.
Yeah, this is like your state vector.
There's no easy way to kind of go about learning and fully explaining how we make decisions. I just started doing this computational modeling a couple months ago, and I'm trying to still wrap my head around it and learn how to program and code and analyze the data. It's just awesome to get this learning experience every single day. And I think that's one of the things that drives me. Being here and having this nice collaborative environment is another huge bonus and another sort of driving force, because I can come in here and be with my friends, but also be with my colleagues and have intellectual discussions about solving unique problems, but coming at them with our own perspectives. I think where I want to end up going with this study and future experiments is to look at how do we learn how to make better decisions when we have these different degrees of dynamically changing information. I think that if you really love science and you want to pursue it in any sort of way, think of some sort of problem that you want to solve and don't give up on whatever inspires you to, pursue the questions that you need some answers to, especially in science and research. And just, don't shy away from any question either.